In this video, we're going to see how to export and import contacts in Outlook 2016. The best way to learn is to start by exporting. That way, you'll see what Outlook needs when it comes to importing again. Go to File, Open and Export, and click on Import Export. A pop-up window gives you a number of options. We'll choose Exporting to a File. You've now got two choices. An Outlook data file, or PST, is used exclusively for transferring contacts between Outlook programs. So let's use the CSV format, which we can view or amend in an Excel spreadsheet. The next pop-up window gives you a number of options to export. We're going to export all of our contacts, so we select that option. Next, we choose where to save the exported file. Give it a name and click Next. You don't want to map custom fields on this export, so we click Finish. The export can take some time depending on the size of your contact list. I've only got one contact for this demonstration, and here's the exported file opened in Excel. The first thing to notice is that each field in the contacts database becomes a column in the spreadsheet, and there are a lot of fields, and not all of them are used. You can now manipulate your contact data in any way you want, creating custom email lists, address lists, or mail merge, or simply exporting to another database. Now, let's look at the reverse procedure, importing contacts from a list. Here's an Excel spreadsheet containing a small number of contacts. The first thing I need to do is to make sure that I use the same field names that Outlook uses. We're going to have to map the columns to Outlook's database field in just a moment, and by using the same field names, Outlook will do it automatically for you. It's worth taking time to make sure your Excel spreadsheet is ready for import. Removing blank or corrupted rows, correcting errors, and above all else, making sure that the first row contains the correct field names, Outlook's field names, and not data. Now save it as a CSV file. If you don't do this, Outlook won't be able to find it. Once your spreadsheet is ready for import, open Outlook, go to File, Opened and Export, Import Export. Select Import from another program or file and click Next. You now have a choice of importing from two file types. We want to import from a CSV file. Click Next and browse to the file that you're going to import. I'm going to allow duplicates for import, though there are two other choices. Replacing or not importing duplicates always runs the risk of missing out important data. Clicking Next allows me to choose the Excel spreadsheet for import, and I then need to choose where in Outlook to import it. I choose the Contacts root folder so that my spreadsheet creates a new folder in Outlook. That's a good way to keep my imported data separate from other Outlook data. Clicking Next takes me to the Import screen, where I can map the columns in my spreadsheet to Outlook's data fields. Because I've used Outlook's field names for my spreadsheet columns, Outlook has automatically done the mapping for me, but it's good to check. Click Next, and there's a final check that the data is in the correct field. You can change it if necessary, but try to avoid this because it's a long job. If you've prepared the spreadsheet carefully, everything should be in the right place. I finally click OK and Finish, and the import starts. Again, if it's a big spreadsheet, it can take a few minutes. Now all I need to do is to check that the data's there in Outlook. Click Address Book and navigate to the imported folder. And there it is, in my Outlook Contacts folder. Job done. eTop Technology, we're here to help. If you like these videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you found this video helpful, check out some of our more recent videos. And if you're looking for a new IT partner, please visit our website.